Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
أنفسنا من سيئات الأعمال يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. We stopped in page 13 for those who follow in the small book. And the Imam Ghazali رحمه الله made another example, and he said that if somebody is sick, a doctor gives him prescriptions or give her prescriptions. They took the prescriptions, they put it on their kitchen table, and they look at it every day. Can they feel better? They didn't use any medicine. They just look the medicine and put it there. So this is medicine, this is medicine. And they want to get better. Can they? قال ومثله أيضا لو كان لرجل حرارة ومرض صفراوي يكون علاجه بالسكينين والكشكاب. يعني he gave what they call it herbal medicine that they used to use for the person have yellow fevers. He says if a person doesn't use the medicine, he will not be able to recover. Then he used two Pharisee poet, which is the many translation of them, but I will give you the gist of them. The same issue of the medicine. If a person have, you know, if a person is hungry or thirsty, and somebody says, I'm gonna really buy you a bottle of water. But the person put the bottle also and look at it. Can having the bottle of, or have it in their hand, can their thirst goes away? And this is an example of a person have knowledge but does not use it. Is a person carrying the water, but he or she is thirsty, but don't realize the water is in their hand. A person is sick, but they don't realize the medicine in front of them. Therefore, a person can have the medicine with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given an example in the Quran, وَثُ الَّذِينَ حُمُلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوهَا كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُوا أَسْفَارًا. He said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give people the Torah or the Quran and they don't apply it, like a donkey that carrying many books that doesn't know what in the books. Okay. ولو قرأت العلم مئة سنة. He said, if you study for 100 years وجمعت ألف كتاب and you have gathered in your head 1,000 books لا تكون مستعدا لرحمة الله تعالى. You have not been prepared for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Illa bil amal. Nothing would take you to the rahmah of Allah except with action. وأن ليس للإنسان إلا ما سعى. وأن ليس للإنسان إلا ما سعى. Allah says in the Quran, no one will get except what they have earned. ولا تزر وازرة إيش وزر أخرى. No one will be held accountable for the sin of the others. No one will get a credit except for things that they strive for. إلا ما سعى. No one will be punished except for what they have done. فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا. Whoever seek to meet the Lord, let them do righteous deeds. ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من كره لقاء الله كره الله لقاءه. Whoever doesn't want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah doesn't want to meet them. Wassalam. You know what that means? Does anyone of here want to meet Allah? in order to meet Allah, what will happen? You have to die. True or not? For Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha said, Ya Rasulullah, who like to die? He said, this is not what I meant. I meant at the moment of death itself. Not before that. No one likes to die. When we are dying, in that process of death, when the soul is leaving, the malaika, the angel, come to a person or a believer. They come and sit next to him or her. الذين تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون. The malaika that surround the person says, don't worry about it. We know you're going to be dying, but we're going to tell you that whatever going to come after this, you will enjoy this so much. We're here to give you glad tidings. We're here to comfort you. We're here to say to you, be patient. Don't worry about it. لا تخاف. Don't get scared. لا تحزن. Don't feel sad. وأبشروا. Giving you good news. بالجنة. Paradise is coming. وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. Why? Allah said, نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا. We are your protector in this life. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. In life to come. ولكم فيها في الآخرة ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم. For a person die in peace. He said, مستعدا لرحمة الله. That's why there's no contradiction between the hadith of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Quran. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا يدخل أحدكم الجنة بعمله. No one enter paradise because of their action. قال ولا أنت يا رسول الله. Even you يا رسول الله. قال ولا أنا. Even me. إلا أن يتغمدني الله برحمته. Unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows his mercy upon me. Then you say, but you read in the Quran says, وَمَنْ كَانْ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا مَزْدُورَ شَذِّدْ. Because, as I said many times in this masjid, the good deeds in the eyes of Allah have been multiplied. You are not being given the same thing. Allah is merciful. You pray one fajr, Allah make it 10 fajr. And they make it 700 fajr. Bonuses left and right. Allah give bonuses. But when a person commits a sin, is considered only one sin. It's merciful. It's out of his kindness, out of his generosity. Allah is al-Kareem. جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the reward or the punishment for what people have earned. جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. And then Allah Almighty says, إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا خالدين فيها لا يبغون عنها حولا. Allah says, and those who believe and do righteous deeds, Allah gives them جنات الفردوس. This not one jannah, جنات الفردوس. كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا. Anyone from Morocco here? Morocco or Tunisia? They call the hotel Nuzul. The hotel. The Arab, the Sudanese and the Egyptian, they call it Funduk. The name in Tunisia and Morocco is more accurate in Arabic. They call it Nuzul. Because Nuzul is and the house they call Manzil, which is also in standard Arabic today. That you get, after a journey, you get to what? You go to the hotel, called Nuzul. The difference between Jannah and the hotel, in Jannah you check in, you never check out. In Jannah, you never feel bored. In Jannah, you own the place, you are not temporary. No one remove you from it. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا لَا يَبْغُونَ عَنْهَا حِوَلًا. You enter paradise, Muhammad, you want to change it? What option do you want to change to go where? لَا يَبْغُونَ عَنْهَا حِوَلًا. Because when people enter Jannah, nothing in Jannah is boring. Because Jannah is the place no one feels bored. Anything you want, you get. You know, in Jannah, I'll give you an example of this. You know, a woman didn't have children in this life. She died and she wanted to have children. She said, oh Allah, I would like to have a child in paradise. Allah can give her a child like he gave to Maryam. Have a child grow up in her womb. She gave birth to a child with no pain. To give her the pleasure of having a child. Another man, he's...
Is the same process like this dunya or different process?
I'm telling you that Allah gave her just a child, just like he gave Maryam alayhi salam.
Is it for 9 months she's going to be pregnant?
No. كان حمله يوما ووضعه يوما. She get pregnant, have a child in the same day, she deliver in the same day. Allah just speeded child. And a person said, Rasulullah said another man, he said, oh Allah, I want to farm. I have a desire of farming. Didn't have everything. You don't need to farm. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted this man his wish. They gave him the seed and he planted, of course, he put something in Jannah. The crops like mountains. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, child of Adam, even when they still have their own wishes. That's what it is. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا. In Surah Al-Furqan, Allah says, except the person who made tawbah and believed and have done righteous deeds. فَأُولَٰئِكَ بَدُّ اللَّهُ سَيَّتُمْ حَسَنًا. But the point here, the Shaykh, the Imam Rahimullah al-Ghazali, point he's making, he said that do not say, I'm a Muslim in my heart, I don't have to pray, I'm a Muslim in my heart, I don't have to fast, I'm a Muslim in my heart, I'm going to drink, I'm a Muslim in my heart, I'm going to commit this, therefore, why Allah would punish me? I'm a nice guy. And how fair it is, Allah said, don't do this, don't do that. And another person listened to Allah, another person didn't listen to Allah. أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ. How are we going to make them equal? وَمَا تَقُولُ فِي هَذِهِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. Then he said to the young man, وَمَا تَقُولُ فِي هَذِهِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. And what you say about this hadith? بُنِيَ الْإِسْلَامُ عَلَى خَمْسٍ. Islam was established on five. شَهَادَةِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ وَصَوْمِ رَمَضَانٍ وَحَجِّ الْبَيْتِ مَنْ سَطَعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. In other words, the Imam saying, if somebody told you, I'm going to practice Islam without these five pillars, they're what? Lip service. They are not true. They have to make the shahada, testify. They have to pray. They have to give zakah. Of course, if they have the money to do so. Fast Ramadan. Do hajj. If they are capable of doing, fulfilling pilgrimage. Those are the five pillars. A person must adhere to those five pillars. Islam is a religion of action. But those are the foundation. Those are pillars. Where is the building? There's pillars and there's a building. What the rest of the building? Kind to your parents, to your neighbors, smile to another person, forgiveness, feeding the hungry, praying at night. This is the rest of the building. Those are the foundation. But there's a building, whole building. But if a person perfect the foundation, they will complete the building. If a person perfect the foundation, they will not leave the pillar standing by themselves. Because those foundation will lead to the rest of Islam. Because the beauty of Islam, if you practice one of it well, it leads to the others. The problem I'm going to share with you, when people partition Islam, and that happened even during Rasulullah's time, and Rasulullah warned them from this. A woman that was very mean and have mistreated and hurt her neighbor, did she pray? Yes. Did she fast? Yes. Did she? But Rasulullah said, what? It's not going to help. Because if a person really pray, the prayer will prevent them from committing what is wrong. Inna salata tanha an al-fahsha'i wal-munkar. A prayer make a person humble. No one is arrogant really have prayed. Salli fa innaka lam tusalli. Pray because you have not prayed. Salli fa innaka lam tusalli. Pray because you have not prayed. Because when a person pray well, is a humble person, naturally. تقبل الصلاة من تواضع بها لعظمة الله. Salah being accepted for a person humbled himself for the mighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولم يستطل بها على خلقي. He does not make them arrogant and look down to people. وأنفق نهاره في ذكري. A person spend the rest of the day in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the impact of the salah. تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. And that's why people ask me, how do I know if I'm religious or not? I say, look to your salah. You pray on time? Do you miss your salah? If you miss your salah, you have a spiritual problem. Forget about all the philosophy and salah. Why? Because salah is an invitation from Allah Almighty. If somebody turned down the invitation from Allah Almighty, what do you expect? بني الإسلام على خمس شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا. Those are five pillars of Islam. والإيمان قول باللسان. الإيمان قول باللسان. إيمان is to what you uttered with your tongue. قول باللسان. وتصديق بالجنان. What is this here? Your heart. Your heart must believe it. Cannot be just coming from the mouth. Has to live here. تصديقٌ بالجنان. وعملٌ بالأركان. The action. A person have to, the limbs and the action of a person is manifestation of their belief and their statement. My brother and sister, let me ask you a question. Have you ever felt a moment that we felt that your iman is really strong? Have you? Have you ever felt a moment that your iman is strong? None of you? What impact the state of the heart? If you go just back and review, three things, and tell me if I'm wrong. Your surrounding, your thought, and your hope. What do I mean by that? What a mindset a person has before he went to the act of worship. What is Hajj? What is the night of 27 of Ramadan? And the feeling of hope that Allah will gonna what? Forgive.
Hassan Basri says, Allah said in the Day of Judgment to his ibad, "Udkhulu ya ibad al-jannah bi rahmati waqtasimuha bi amalikum." Allah says, enter my paradise by my mercy and divide it among you with what? With your deeds. Can I give you, is anyone sitting here as a mother or a father? If you raise our children well and the parents or the children become the higher than the parents in paradise, see, if the children and the parents, both of them enter paradise, follow Ameen, inshallah. If what, the parents in the higher place or the child in the higher place? By the way, we'll say higher place. We're not saying the second floor. We're going to take the elevator and just go the upstairs. Al-Jannah 100 daraja. Paradise at 100 degree level. Between every degree and another degree is like a distance between heaven and earth. You have to really fly, huh? Space shuttle. When a person is in high place, say, oh Allah, I would like to have, I know that my children somewhere, yeah, paradise. I would like to have family reunion. I want my family and me to be together. He or she. Or the child says, I want my parents. Allah Almighty the Kareem. Grant the reunion. You bring them together. Isn't it good news, brother Rida? A family reunion in paradise. Can you imagine that? A family reunion in paradise?
What if some of them are in hell?
Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring them to paradise after, you know, being forgiven. After they enter, if they die in Tawheed, they will enter in Jannah. And then they will be elevated. Subhanallah, ya akhi. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ بِإِيمَانٍ. This is Quran. أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ أَوْ ذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ وَمَا أَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَمْلِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ كُلْ مُرِيمٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِيمٍ. Those who believe, and the children follow them in belief, to reunite them. Subhanallah. What do you say, Yahya?
This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, enter Jannah bi rahmah, which is because of His rahmah, not because of our deeds.
Rahmah, and then you divide it
according to you, not because of your deeds. Because of His rahmah.
يَقَالُ لِقَارِئِ الْقُرْآنِ اقْرَأْ وَارْتَقِي اقْرَأْ وَارْتَقِي. In their paradise, he or she, if he will recite Quran in this dunya, اقرأ وارتقي. Recite Quran. فإن منزلتك عند آخر آية تقرأها. You'll be elevated according to the last verse that you're going to recite. Subhanallah. أيها الولد. I'm speeding up because I'm all in the number five. I'm going faster. أيها الولد. ما لم تعمل لم تجد الأجر. If you do not act upon what you believe, you will not be what rewarded. حكي أن رجلا من بني إسرائيل. Was narrated that a man from Bani Israel عبد الله تعالى 70 سنة. Worship Allah for 70 years. وأراد الله تعالى أن يجلوه على الملائكة. الله سبحانه وتعالى want to show the ملائكة يجلوه على يظهره. Allah want to show the ملائكة this man. You know, Allah سبحانه وتعالى have the ملائكة to experience so many things with us. Do you think there's ملائكة in this room now?
Yes.
Do you believe it?
Yes.
There's angels in this room. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, lillahi malaika, sayyaru, angels, that their mission is to come down on earth seeking the place where the dhikr of Allah. When people remember Allah. When they gather, when they find people sitting like this, they said, come, come down. We found them, we found them. SubhanAllah, they spot you. We found them. They come and surround the people. Until the halaqah finished. They go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows what they will have been. But like you ask your children, tell me your report card. They give you the report card. Then your uncle comes in, or their uncle says, come, what did you get in the report card? Your father knows or doesn't know. But you want the child to feel good about themselves. They tell many people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks the angels, where have you been? Does he know where you have been or not? They said, we come, جِئْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِ اللَّكِ. We come from servants of yours. مِنْ عِبَادِ اللَّكِ. And Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them, what those people are doing? What were they doing? He said, oh Allah, they were praising you. They were glorifying you. Then Allah Almighty said, have they seen me? Did they see me? قَالُوا لَا. Oh, they have not seen me. He said, what they, if they have seen me? So Allah, they will glorify you more and more. And then he asked them, what they are really asking? What? They said they asked him for paradise. قال يسألونك الجنة قال أحرأها. Have they have seen my paradise? قال يا الله ما رأوها. They have not seen paradise. قال كيف لو رأوها. What if they have seen it? My brothers and sisters, this is still in Virginia, isn't it? If this wall were to be moved now, or the veil been taken, and all of us will be looking to paradise now. If we're to see Jannah now, what? How do you go back home? What kind of drive would you have home? SubhanAllah, yeah. If they have seen it, what if they have seen it? They said, if they see it, they will seek it more. They will strive more to get it. What they seek refuge from? They seek refuge from hellfire. Have they seen hellfire? Have you seen it? My brothers and sisters, this using of the word hell very loosely. Oh, my days was hell today. My days was hell. Please stop that. Just not ordinance. No one should use that kind of language. Really? You heard that before or not? You heard it every day. I've been living in hell. What do you mean? What do you mean? He says, have they seen it? They say, oh Allah, they have not seen it. He said, what if they have seen it? They say, we'll do everything to distance themselves from it. Then Allah Almighty says, well, there's a punchline here. He says, and what they asking for? They say, oh Allah, they ask you to forgive them. Ya Allah, they ask you to forgive them. Allah then says, Ushhidukum ya malaikati, O my angels, I make you witness that I forgive all of them. This hadith in Bukhari. Ushhidukum ya malaikati, inni qad ghafartu lahum. Allahu Akbar. Then the malaika said, oh Allah, Allah knows. They want to know, if this means everybody? The malaika said, oh Allah, but how about so-and-so who just dropped by, he didn't really want to come, but somebody dragged him to it or said something, come. How about that person? Allah says, even him or her and forgive them, بِكَهُمُ الْقَوْمُ لَا يَشْقَى بِهِمْ جَلِيسُهُمْ. They are kind of people, the person in the company will not be deprived. Collective mercy, mercy by association. What is this? لا إله إلا الله. نجلوه للملائكة. فأرسل إليه ملكا يخبره. Allah wants to tell them how some people worship Allah on this earth. Telling the malaika, when he sent an angel in the form of a man, says, go tell this person this, this, and that. يخبره. أنه مع تلك العبادة. He said, what if with all of this worship, you are not fit enough to enter paradise? If with all of this act of worship, you are not fit enough to enter paradise, what will you do? Isn't that amazing? 70 years. He said, after the 70 years of worshiping Allah, what if of all of the 70 years, you're not fit enough? لا يلوق به أن يدخل الجنة. به دخول الجنة. When the angel told him this, look to this servant. This is a person, don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they want that job or this job or that. They worship Allah because Allah deserves to be worshipped. قال العابد نحن خلقنا للعبادة. So Allah created me to begin with to worship Him. I was not created for another purpose. I'm here fulfilling a mission of creation. خلقنا للعبادة. فينبغي لنا أن نعبده. We have to worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى. The outcome I leave it to Allah, but I'm going to continue worshiping Allah سبحانه وتعالى. I leave the outcome to Him. ولما رجع الملك, when the angel went back, قال إلهي أنت أعلم بما قال. Oh Allah, you know what he said. I don't have to tell you what he said. وقال الله تعالى إذا هو لم يعرض عن عبادتنا فنحن مع الكرم لا نعرض عنه اشهدوا يا ملائكتي أني قد غفرت له. He says, this man does not turn away from us in all conditions. I make you witness all my angels that I forgive this man. لا تعرض عن العبادة because the job is not being given. لا تعرض عن العبادة because the engagement is broken. لا تعرض عن العبادة because marriage didn't work out. لا تعرض عن العبادة because you lost a loved one. لا تعرض عن العبادة because you lost money in the stock market. Don't let the ibadah because you lost your business. You worship him because he's the one who gave the business, the one who gave the life, the one who gave the dunya. Don't make a dunya criteria for relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None of this dunya deserves to be between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created the dunya to take us to him. When he take it away, because one has only to have him. And when you give it, to get to him. If you take it, to get to him. And all him, if that matters. And that was the meaning of La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. That's what it means of it. It's a shahada. Shahada is to witness there's nothing of importance in this dunya. There's nothing of great, you know, importance except Allah Almighty. That's why when they used to say La ilaha illallah, they used to say it from here, not from here. That's why the arifin, when they say La ilaha illallah, they cry. Because the heart, it just evaporates. There's an electric shock. There's a beautiful breeze comes from the heart to the eyes. When it's windy, sometimes you have tears in your eyes. This is the wind of Iman. For the breeze comes from here, to the eyes. And that's why Imam Malik, rahimahullah, he says, they said to him, why you go to Muhammad ibn al-Munkadir just looking at his face? You leave your home to look to another person? قال كنت إذا شعرت بقساوة في قلبي, when my heart is hard, I go to Muhammad ibn al-Munkadir just looking at him. فيرق قلبي أياما, my heart becomes soft for days to come. Why? لأنه ما ذكر بالله إلا بكى. Mention Allah names, his eyes become like تفيض أعينهم إيش من الدمع. الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم. I'm going to give you an exercise, and none of you want to think this is bid'ah. It's just an exercise. I want for 2 minutes to say La ilaha illallah deep from our heart. La ilaha illallah. 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 I want you to do this. Try it at home. Listen, after all my experience in this country, 25 years, I come to know nothing really keeps you connected except a moment of dhikr that you do by yourself. رَجُلٌ ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ خَالِيًا فَفَاضَ الْعَيْنَاهُ. A person remember Allah alone and their eyes become full of tears. Do it in the car. Who's driving now to 20 minutes? Anyone driving 20 minutes, 10 minutes? In your car. Say, La ilaha illallah. That's Rasulullah sallam qad hadith. أَفْضُلُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي. The best thing I have said and those prophets before me is what? La ilaha illallah. For this man said, Allah created for to worship him. There's no other reason. That's why I just want to say that our health, our wealth, our prestige, all of it are the tool to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When He give them, for that reason. When He take them, for that reason. To remind us of Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For we need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this moment to give shifa to anyone who is sick. Because this is اللهم أشي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم أشي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم أشي مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم يا ربنا يا عظيم يا حليم إنا نسألك أن تصلح فساد قلوبنا أصلح فساد قلوبنا ردنا إليك ردا جميلا توفنا وأنت راض عنا توفنا على لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك جزاك الله خير السلام. الله أكبر الله أكبر.